So, well, hi there. This is another project for me. It's a video about receivers. And first I'm going to show you a simple receiver that many people used to build, and some of them are happy with it, but I'm not really happy with it. It's a one transistor FM receiver. And I'll demonstrate that it works. I'll plug in the battery. And you can hear the local station. But as you can hear, eventually the sound is really bad. And on the other side, I have built a real radio, a so-called superhead receiver. That is a project in a radio experiments box. And this receiver receives the signal very good. I'll show you that. Okay, I have to retune it. Oh, it works. Okay, and this is especially about FM receivers, because building a FM receiver is a really complicated project. Here you have the one transistor radio that works, but it's actually an AM receiver. And here you have got a real FM receiver. See how many circuits I need for this. And even I'm using integrated circuits, this is still a pretty complex circuit. So on an FM receiver you have different tank circuits. This is the input circuit matching the antenna. This is the circuit for the local oscillator. This is, as you can read, the mixer module. This is the filter, and this is the demodulator. This is pretty complex. So this radio, or most FM radios, do generate two frequencies. Or better, they generate a frequency by their own. I'll show you that soon. Now let's listen to the music. Meanwhile, I adjust the scanner. So you can see it, hopefully. So this superhead radio is rebroadcasting the signal to a defined frequency of 10.7 MHz. And then these 10.7 MHz go into the demodulator. The really, really tricky thing is to demodulate the frequency signal, the frequency modulated signal. On AM, you can simply demodulate it with a diode or with a transistor, but on FM, it's really complicated. You need a so-called discriminator, which is this circuit here, that produces from the FM signal an AM signal, and then demodulates the AM signal. This part here is not so complicated. You have a local oscillator that is 10.7 MHz higher than the receiver frequency, and you also have your tank circuit to match the antenna for the best reception. Then it goes to a filter that filters out the 10.7 MHz. That is simply because it gets mixed down, so you have a constant frequency that can be easier amplified, and you don't need a complex circuit with many variable capacitors and coils. But this one here, building this with transistors, is still one thing that is really, really tricky, and at this time when I'm making this video, I'm not able to build such this thing only with transistors. I don't know how it works. I think it does something with the 180 degree phase shift thingy. I have no idea. I just want to show you how complicated these things are. That is a circuit for a normal radio. So you can receive the whole FM band with this, and it sounds exactly like a normal radio. No distortion, good sound and everything. Meanwhile, this one here, the regenerative receiver, is not really good. I've built it and I've experimented with it a lot today, and I'm not really happy, as I said, because you have the chance, the choice. So I turn it on. So I can either have sound like this, you may hear it, but I'll hold the box to the camera, the loudspeaker. Okay, as you could hear eventually, the sound is not really good. And here you can adjust the sound quality, if you want to call it like this, because we are demodulating FM on the edge of the frequency with this circuit. So I have set up a small AM transmitter on 108 MHz, which is crystal controlled, and I'll show you that this receiver will pick up the AM transmitter even better than the other transmitter. Okay, wait. That's the AM transmitter. That is how clear the AM transmitter sounds on my FM receiver. But as you can see, it's an AM receiver actually, and we are receiving FM with it, and as you heard before, the sound is really bad. If you want to receive this transmitter, which generates an AM signal, with this radio you won't hear it. You will only hear a very, very silent signal with much distortion. So this is just something I wanted to show you. AM receiver. Easy, easy, easy to build. FM receiver, really, really, really tricky to build. I mean, I'm using integrated circuits, or better, the electronic box is using integrated circuits. Imagine all these kinds of devices here built directly with transistors. That would be a huge circuit board. Okay, I'm just wanting to show you that, because actually I was wanting to show you this receiver here, but I'm not really happy with this quality. The quality is not good, and that was why I'm making this video, or I made this video. I wanted to show you this receiver here, which is a superhead receiver that can be found in radios like this. This is also a superhead receiver, I'm sure, and this is the cheap version of it, an FM receiver, a FM receiver. So if you want ever to build the FM receiver, use a complex circuit like this, you will get good results. Or use the TDA-7000 radio SC. That will work as well. I've seen many people getting good results with this thing, with the small receiver. They are having a good audio quality and something like that. It is possible to get a good signal, but it's so tricky to tune and so unreliable. So once again, this is more or less a review of a FM receiver. And that was the video for the FM receivers. Best wishes and greetings from Stefan.